I just want to go to this final point, though, Kristin, because a lot of people are speculating this big contest here, a monumental election choice here. But to me, the point here is that we have a contest between two known quantities. We know what Donald Trump's like as president because he was president only 3.5 years ago. And we also know what Kamala Harris would be like as president because she's part of the administration now. She's the serving vice president. But have a look at this grab. And it's like she pretends she's not even in power at the moment.
So when asked this question about how will this affect my life in terms of a voter worrying about the fact that, look, price of groceries still too high. I get it, they get it. And what are we doing to help them actually get through life in a way that they're not just getting by but getting ahead? We have to have specific policies that do that. And that is what I offer under what I call an opportunity economy approach.
Kristin, they need policies. She's in the White House now. She has an office as vice president in the White House now. Why on earth hasn't she been doing anything? She's saying, elect me and then I'll do something?
It's ridiculous. She's effectively trying to run against her own track record while simultaneously, claiming she's going to be the new, fresh candidate, a time for change. It's completely ridiculous. You were correct earlier, I suspect, when you said, we know these candidates at this point. There are no surprises here, which is why this race will ultimately probably come down to turning out the candidate's own bases. And right now, things could change. We still got a couple weeks, but right now, the left's base is feeling deflated. The sugar high when they first announced her has worn off, and they are realizing they're stuck with this empty suit. There's no there with Kamala Harris. She's empty. She's vacuous. And she can't handle the most simple of questions. And the Democrats are now realizing that.
Yeah, great insights there, Kristin. Thanks for catching up again. We'll talk next week.
Thanks, as always, Chris.